bitch, then you fools hurt. Jesus, well.
Southern California has a new modern home for NFL football, and it is this place, wondrous SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the San Francisco 49ers and the Los Angeles Chargers.
Matt Gay set to kick off.
It's the final 3 weeks of the season. Still plenty to play for here as we're underway in week 15. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Seven, past the 30 to the 32.
He's tackled it.
This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead him to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
That's complete to his receiver, Ayuk. 11 yards there, first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Call it a pickup of seven, and that'll bring up second down.
At the 50-yard line.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
And the 49er first down.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Here's a 2nd and 7. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First down, 49ers.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Brings up 2nd and 12 at the 34-yard line.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12. He'll look to throw. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arm.
And trying to get it to Samuel, but it's intercepted. Picked off near the 29. And a big return will get him all the way down to the 35. So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them and an absolute shock for the quarterback because he went into it. He saw the numbers we saw. He watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day, and it very well could be. But early in this one, advantage defense.
Nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
But defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and trying not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
On 2nd and 10, the ball back with Herbert. Complete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. 3rd down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Going to throw on 3rd down with Herbert. 4th down now as San Fran's defense was strong in coverage.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
And that one will be no good. He never had it online. It's well wide to the left, and this will remain a scoreless game. Now listen, now no kick from 50-plus is a gimme, but here you're indoors in a dome, you'd think ideal conditions.
Yeah, and it's one that he would expect himself to make, not just us expecting him to make it. Over the years, my theory is very simple. The athletic ability of kickers continues to get better and better. Check their background. They were all county, all state, and other positions, not just soccer players. These guys expect themselves to be great as well.
And he's got this down to the 35. Give him 14 on that one and a 1st down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on 1st down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he'll be close to a 1st down at the Chargers' 20-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league, had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Lots of screen pass, that's complete. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8.
Complete.
A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door.
Nice little nifty play for them there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down.
Second and goal.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. And he's got it. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a third and goal.
And that's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
And he hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. George Kittle with touchdown number 7 on the year, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. And the 49ers grab a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Niners 7, Chargers nothing.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Fielded in the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah,
you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Herbert. Henry brings it in. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Behind the chains, 2nd and 13. Out of the gun, Eckler running it. Room to run past midfield. And finally they get him to the ground, but it's all the way down at the Niners 26. 36 yards on the play. A lot of running backs, a little bit of a disadvantage when you start talking MVP. Might not be the case this year. You think he's got a shot, don't you?
I do. I think he's got more than a shot. But what he's going to need here down the stretch this late in the season, he needs that big closing game, that game that we're all going to...
to account for now 8 interceptions on the year.
I love that number because I always think of center field. You know, when I hear 8, because that's the position you write in the scorecard in baseball. And what do good center fielders do? Take
away
all the alleys, right? They range deep and make a whole lot of great catches.
And he will lose yardage here back to his own six. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. They'll look to throw. Looking for Ayuk, and he's got it. And right around the 20, he'll head out of bounds. Give him 14 on that one, and a first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
For the incompletion here, second and 10 from the 20. And he'll give it here to his running back. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Ball carried by number
not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Complete, and he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down San Francisco, the pickup 14 yards. They'll look to throw here. Slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 10 more there and another first down.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
And down he goes at the 49, a three-yard pickup. A gain of three, second down.
A three-yard pickup. Brings up second and 7.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. They'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy. As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
This will be the 8th play of the drive. It's 3rd and 7. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. They're trying to get it to Samuel, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 40. And they will finally stop him as he's down the 40-yard line. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Back to to throw now on first down. And that's incomplete.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Intercepted. Derwin James with a pick, and they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. He's continuing to be a big presence defensively. Remember last week, AFC Defensive Player of the Week, and a big pick right there.
And when you pile up big numbers, it gets everyone's attention, but sometimes the number just needs to be, how many game-changing plays did you make? Did you take the ball away from the other team? He just did that, trying to win the award again this week.
Here's Eckler to begin the drive. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Gun, Herbert. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. First down, Justin Herbert. Going right, and that's complete. Given 9 there on the first down completion. And Charles, a couple extra defensive backs in here on 3rd and 1.
Not expecting them to run it at all.
They'll try to pick up the first with Eckler. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. A shotgun snap for Herbert. He'll get this to Eckler. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Chargers, first down. 1st and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Down, it's Herbert. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock.
On the throwaway. Makes it 2nd and 10 at the 21-yard line.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash, it's a 38-yard attempt. Gay's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Chargers going to get the football first here in the second half, and they trail as we get back underway. The Charger drive about to get going.
And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. Maybe a good spot to take a shot here, second and a yard from the 34. Herbert. Looking now, and that's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Running on first down, Eckler. And some space here. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. For 33 and a first. What did you see there on the defensive side? What allowed that good size run?
Well, they were in a cover two alignment, which means your two safeties are back away from the line of scrimmage. So if you can match up your blocking at the line, at the point of attack, there's usually some room, a big gap between that second level and third, and that's what they were able to exploit.
First down, and they stick with Eckler. And he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. Wide open receiver complete. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. From 19 yards away. And the Chargers have taken the lead.
All the receivers in the league are plenty good enough. Otherwise, they wouldn't make it in the NFL. But the ones that go to the Pro Bowl, they have refined route running ability.
After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily to look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers.
And eight at the 27-yard line.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Here's a first down throw. It's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line.
complete.
That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
It's second and inches at the 45-yard line.
Running back, and he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed, but all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. He's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. Another catch for him there. This one good for 11. First down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
The tackle made that time by Dalvin Tomlinson.
No gain on the
ladies play. And gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
A good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a three-point game. Second and 10. They're going to look to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. So that one will be accepted. They'll look to throw now on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Second and seven at the Chargers' 22-yard line.
Catching the slam. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
To George,
they call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down.
10-yard line.
It'll be first and goal when we come back. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for them in that situation.
They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. To the 9. A 5-yard loss there is going to bring up fourth down.
And now with where they are after that loss,
I think conventional wisdom says you have to kick the field goal and tie the game. But if you've got a play that you really love, now's your opportunity to call it.
And his kick is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net. But they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
5 yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter. He finds an opening past the 40. And finally brought down right at the midfield stripe. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. From the 50, here's Herbert. That's into the hands of Eckler. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
On 3rd down, Herbert. And hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because it nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback.
20-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. The drive starts with a completion left side, and he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
The 24-yard line.
Throw here. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
I like what I'm seeing from them here. A tie game in the fourth quarter. They understand the situation. They don't need to be in any rush. Go ahead and huddle up and run your offense. That last completion put them in a nice position to take the lead in this game.
Now they try the right side here. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has 3 options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football for triple option, you've actually called that play.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a score to break this tie. Second and 14. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Gosh, given the time and the short game, would he have been better off just dropping that?
Yeah, when you look at the clock, you think so. But it's hard to get a receiver to drop a football. They're trained to catch everything.
And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. To the ground with another first down at the Chargers 31-yard line.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming. Let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Now a handoff looking right. He spins free. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Brings up third down.
This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's third and a yard. And again, this time to the tailback. And he is going to have a Niners first down. At least it would appear that way. He didn't get it by much, but yes, they do get the conversion on third and one. And we are set for a great finish as that timeout comes in with 2 seconds to go in this football game. And now this game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. 2 seconds on the clock, this for the win. Good. The kick is good, and that writes a crazy finish to this one. Well, a little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory was theirs, and that's exactly what they did.
So for San Francisco, they remain in the hunt for a first-round bye as they move to 11-3 on the year. And they will head home next week to take on the Seattle Seahawks. Meanwhile, for the Chargers, this was basically just an exhibition game for them as they'd already clinched home field advantage. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Foxborough to face off against the New England Patriots. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.